Look at us. Don't flinch, blink, shirk. We have power within us to wipe away that smirk. Our heritage makes us claim this stage. This doesn't come from arrogance or embarrassment, but from intelligence that we want to share with you. A story resonating with relevance. Look at us. Observe the seduction of our skin, shimmering and sparkling, a glimmering, glittering crustacean.
Look in admiration as we undergo suffocation, as the glitter solidifies and prevents respiration.
Take a knife.
Axe the armor.
Shred the skin. Heal the plastic.
Slay the foundations.
Leave us breathing.
Sores bleeding.
Yet that feeling of the glitter sinking, no longer glimmering and deceiving, but revealing how loud we were screaming. We stand before you.
Our names have been erased before they were written down.
Our voices silenced before we opened our mouths.
Our bodies broken before we could run. We stand before you. Philomena.
Pierced, poked, penetrated by terriers. Transformed into a nightingale, singing her muted melody.
Medusa.
Clutched, choked, carved by Poseidon. Immortalized into a monster, accepted by the whole world as her deserved destiny.
Daphne, slapped, stroked, strangled by Apollo, twisted into a laurel tree. The Olympic wreath we now wear to symbolize victory. These stories are the threads of society's tapestry, interwoven and accepted as normality. From generation to generation, we've come to believe that these stories suppressing us are reality.
Look at us. We stand before you carrying a glass full of water.
In a distance, the glitter is beautiful.
Everything is beautiful from a distance, isn't it?
Until we magnify it.
In the room, the editor
is perched on her swivel chair behind her mahogany desk, facing one.
I can feel my breath in the room. Today, this interview, it could make me from a woman who works in a coffee shop and does art into a woman who does art and buys coffee from the coffee shop. So I had to have the bag just so that I could breathe just for a moment.
Bit of a juxtaposition, isn't it?
Your work is...
Could I have some water?
Water?
Yeah,
There's water in our section.
Because I had a biscuit, so I've got a cough.
Right. Does your work interest you?
Oh yeah, it does. It does very much. I want to yell the words just to make them slightly more convincing.
I absolutely adored your portfolio. It was very...
She has got a bogey hanging from the side of her nose. It's one of those things you want to just kind of tell her about, but... You can't, because then you look like a twat, and not just a normal twat, but an overbearing judgmental twat, which is much worse.
Lyrical. The pattern that you create on your canvas has a certain aesthetic to it, a melody. Reminds me very much of...
I am watching, not listening. I am watching the corners of her beak bob up and down as if they're being tugged by invisible strings, up and down like a ventriloquist bird. Yeah, totally.
So you do agree?
I do.
Do you?
Yeah.
Your work is interesting. Beautiful, in fact. But personally, I feel that you as an artist needs space to grow and develop. So instead of commissioning you one lesson, I love a pretty picture. But for me to commission you, I need more. An artist creates work that is painful, dirty, truthful, grotty, viscerally violent.
Painful? We've got pain to tell,
have we?
What about that time when you lied to your nan when she was paralysed, plastic, in a hospital bed so you could drink gin and tonic
on a rooftop bar?
Or when you pretended to cry so you could get off the phone faster?
Or when you recited something tragic from your childhood so your teacher would
pressurise you?
Yes, yes.
Have you ever been in love?
Depends what she means by love, doesn't it? You love peanut butter.
No, she loves clean bed sheets.
Have you lost anything?
Lost? What have you lost?
You can lose a key.
You can lose your life.
You can lose your virginity.
You can lose yourself.
Lost something that's precious to you.
Lose yourself. Lose a part of yourself. In yourself. In someone else.
Have you been hurt? Have you been scared? Have you loved? Have you cried? How much do you feel? Has something of consequence happened to you? Have you been vulnerable? Have you lost control? Look closer, one. Magnify yourself. Who are you? What story do your scars tell? What is the picture only you can paint?